Hi everyone, it's Eva Pietrzak here from Abundant Results Coaching, and today I'd love to talk to you about one of your biggest enemies in entrepreneurship, and namely fear. So we've done some fun exercise over the weekend, and if you're part of our Six Figures Entrepreneur Facebook community, you may have seen it. We have done something that we don't usually do. We did a little dance-off to raise our spirits and to have some fun, basically, with everybody. And what was really interesting to notice was hundreds of comments and likes and, oh, I'm gonna do it, and then very few videos joining us in the challenge. So basically, the challenge was to do like a one-minute dance-off movie, to dance in front of your TV to a specific song that we were suggesting and post it in the group. And so a lot of people got excited about it, a lot of people commented on it and loved our video, but very few people actually took on the challenge in the sense of actually recording their own video. And it got me really thinking how fearful we are of what do people think of ourselves. And I wanted to record this video because if this fear is stopping you from something that is fun like this, it definitely stops you in your business. And I used to be controlled by this fear a lot. I grew up in a small countryside back in Poland, and I also grew up in a Catholic family, and every time we went to church, you know, my mom would be like worrying, what do people think of us in terms of how we're dressed? And it was always like, what does the neighbor think of you? And I think there's a lot of that fear in business when it comes to doing something new, when it comes to going out there and doing your money generating activities, when it comes to creating regular content on social media, like your posts or lives, and really putting yourself out there, even when it comes to posting a fun video in the Facebook group. We don't do it because there is this fear of being criticized, of fear of what people think of us, or fear of being imperfect. Whereas the whole purpose of the exercise was to just be loose and imperfect and goof off and have fun. And what's really interesting to notice is there were even some people who did it, they were afraid and they felt liberated after. And that's how you feel when you bust through your fears. So let's talk a little bit about fear, because today we're going to talk specifically about fear of what do people think of me, or fear of criticism. You may be stopped by this fear when it comes to your sales activities in the business, or even marketing activities like putting yourself out there every day on social media. And it's a crippling fear. I used to suffer from this fear a lot, and you may know my story already. For 15 years, I wasn't able to read or speak in front of people, not even a paragraph of text, without shaking, shivering, and stuttering and running out the door. And then within 3 months working with Bob Proctor's material, doesn't matter how long I've tried for 15 years with all sorts of specialists, nothing was helping. But after just 3 months of working with Bob Proctor's material, I stood in front of 70 people in one room here in Dublin in a hotel, and I had no trace of fear. And there's two ways to deal with your fear that I want to talk to you about today. If you are honest with yourself, and you look into why am I not doing what I should be doing in the business, you will notice that frequently fear is the culprit. Fear is the reason why you're not doing it. And so let's talk about fear of what people think of you. First of all, the only fear that you should be afraid of, the only fear that is valid in your life is physical danger. So, you know, let's say you imagine that you are in a jungle and a bear, like literally massive bear, wants to eat you up, you should be afraid. If you have a gun stuck to your skull, you should be afraid. But most of the time we are afraid of things that are not real danger. Like, you know, you going out there and making a mistake in a Facebook Live is not physical danger. It's just psychological fear. And fear, to be honest, like what that really is a psychological reaction of your present like your present blueprint. So we have a blueprint called paradigms. We have our typical habitual thinking patterns and behaviors. And that is controlling our comfort zone. So every time you're stepping out and you're doing something that is not normal for you, is not usual, you're going to have fears, worries, and doubts. And it's a psychological process, nothing to do with actual danger. So I can be telling you all of this, and you can understand it, and you can even agree with me. Yes, if I know, okay, this fear is stupid, it doesn't make any sense, but you're still not going to do what you need to do in your business. So let's talk about techniques or what you need to learn in order to overcome your fears. Well, first, we have techniques in the moment. So when you understand that if your fear is not physical danger, then it's an illusion, it's just projection of your mind, there's things that you can do in the moment when you're experiencing this fear. So let's say you're about to go Facebook Live on a regular basis or produce social media or go sailing, prospecting, follow-ups, anything that you might be afraid of, and you decide, you know what, I need to do this because that's going to make me grow my business. And you're afraid. And sometimes it's to the point of paralysis, you know, like your body is going into anxiety. You've got to understand that the fear is a natural projection of your mind, and your current comfort zone is defending itself by projecting fear, worry, and doubt. And in order to reduce it, there is a written exercise that you can do that will help you make the fear smaller and you do the right thing anyway. So how do we do this? Well, you write down all of your fears. So let's tackle the fear of what do people think of me, right? Let's say you want to go live every day or three times a week. You want to go selling, prospecting, follow-ups, all those things that are scary. Or maybe you want to hire an assistant that could elevate so much, you know, take so much off your plate, and you could be having more work-life balance, but you're scared. And so here's what you do. You take a blank piece of paper and you write out without judgment, what are my fears? What are my biggest fears? So let's say, what do people think of me, or making mistake and people making negative comments, right? And then you want to ask yourself several questions. Number one, if that fear happens, if that fear manifests, so let's say you're going Facebook Live three times a week or maybe once every day, and you're afraid that people will judge you or reject you or make negative comments. And you write that out. You know, I'm afraid people would reject me, will criticize me or make negative comments. Okay, so the first question is, are you going to die or go broke or go under the bridge? And you seriously ask yourself that question if this fear manifests. And you respond. So typically, it's a no, right? When someone makes a critical comment of you or someone rejects you or whatever, you're not going to go down the tube. But this is what your mind is thinking. Your mind goes into fight or flight response. And it, for the mind, is like survival mode. The second question is, okay, so let's say my worst fear manifests. So someone criticizes me in the comments, or someone, I don't know, laughs at what I did, or what will I do? So the second question is, how will I cope with it if it happened? So if the worst case scenario happened, how would I survive? And so the ideas could be, well, I could hide the comment. I don't even have to engage. I could have a pep talk with someone who supports me. And then I focus on the light, on those people that love following me and listening to what I have to say. And I will just shut myself away from the darkness. The third one is, what can I do today or this week or this month to help me reduce the likelihood of this fear? So there are things that you can do in order to reduce the level of fear, or even the likelihood of what you're afraid that will happen of happening. So what you can do is, for instance, you can train how you do Facebook Lives. You can brainstorm with mentor or your colleagues in the field, or even look at other people's Facebook Lives and see what they're doing well, and you can practice and you can train. And then there's so many things that you can do. And then the last question is, how much does it cost me emotionally and financially if I don't do what I said I will do? So let's say if you're dealing with fear of, you know, reaching out to people, prospecting or follow-ups or sales, or regular social media exposure, that, well, the consequences are dramatic for your business, right? You're not going to have the business, you're not going to have the income you want, and you're not going to have the customers that you want, not to mention emotional consequences that you're basically not going to fulfill your dreams. And so basically what you do every time you're afraid, you sit down with a blank sheet of paper, and it has to be done in writing. I mean, it just does something, does a trick to your emotional side. And so what you do, you basically challenge your fear on these four levels. You write it all out, and then your fear typically becomes smaller, and now you can go and do what you want to do. So that's the quick fix, and it works very well when you're about to make a life-changing decision, when you're about to create new habit in your business that is outside of your comfort zone, when you're about to do things that are uncomfortable but you really want to do them because you really care for your goals. So that's the quick fix in the moment. Now, I personally had deep fears, like around public speaking and reading. And as I said to you, within 3 months, they were wiped out. Now, how were they wiped out completely? Because fear typically doesn't leave you completely. It just, you can reduce it a little bit with this exercise that I just said, but typically it doesn't just go. And the reason why it left me completely was because I removed the root cause of the fear. And the root cause of my fear around public speaking and reading was actually my self-image paradigm. So if you've been following me for quite some time, you may have heard me talk about self-image, or you may have heard me talk about paradigms. So paradigms are like systems of thinking habits and the systems of behavioral habits that are controlling 95% of what you do and what you don't do in the business, and they're invoking self-sabotage and fear. And so for me, that system of thinking habits called self-image was basically what I deeply thought of myself. What I deeply thought of myself was causing me to be afraid of other people's opinions, to worry what people think of me, and to be really concerned with making mistakes. Once I retrained my mind to have very healthy self-image or self-esteem, I wasn't worried anymore. So basically that fear didn't have any place in my life. And when I stood on stage after 15 years of shaking, shivering, and stuttering, there was no fear. It was joy. It was connection. It was just like, in fact, this was the time when I identified what I wanted to do in my life, which is be in front of people and help them with what I've got. And so if you're interested to get over your fears permanently, well, then you will need to look into shifting your paradigms, shifting your blueprint, whether it's your thinking or behavioral patterns that are creating and invoking your fear. Now, something like this cannot be done in just short tutorial like this. It's not a quick fix. We would have to work with each other for a period of time. But it doesn't actually have to be long period of time. As I said to you, for over 3 months, my fear was completely wiped out. So if you feel that you are being controlled by your fear, and it's like literally sabotaging your behavior when it comes to earning money, making sales in your business, then we'd love to talk to you, because we have solutions that can help you eradicate the root cause of your fears for the rest of your life. And when that happens, then you're just free to do whatever you want to do and whatever is going to give you that desired income per month in your business. So if this would interest you, then I will pop a quick link here. You can book a quick chat with one of our team members and look into what can be done. And we will review where you are, where you want to be, what's the missing links. We will talk to you about this. And if we can help you, we will also help you. So if this speaks to you, click on the link, book a call. This is a free call, non-binding. But if it turns out that we are the right fit, of course, we're going to get over your fears and make 10K or 20 or 50 per month. So why not, right? So anyway, thank you so much for watching. I hope what I've just shared gives you a little bit of perspective on your fears, and you won't feel so sabotaging yourself every single day as much as in the past. Thank you so much for being here, and have a wonderful week.